broadcast is brought to you by the Public Morals Office of the Order of Salvation. Please pray and thank Almighty God for allowing us to see another dawn.
Welcome to our hotel. We eagerly await your next visit.
Hey, morning!
I must finish today's prayers.
I'm so sorry, but I'm out of flour, so I haven't been able to bake today.
Marlin, you're so kind to come all this way just to tell me that. Never mind, I'll just have extras tomorrow.
You won't have to wait that long, I promise. I'll be back later.
I've decided to tell Renolf the truth. The cold, harsh, unforgiving truth of his past. Even though it could cause him to lose a dear friend. Renolf, I know who killed your family. He lives right here in Luxarian. He's been in hiding since he committed that crime.
Are you sure? Who is he?
The man's name is Reddick. His home is in the Warren for obvious reasons, and I found out something else about him, too. But I'm not sure you really want to hear it.
I'd like to know, please. I'm done running from the past. I'd even forgotten about the family I once loved. From now on, I'm seeing things for what they really are.
All right. This Reddick, the man who killed your family, he has a stepson. His name... it's Marlin.
What? You mean my Marlin?
What are you going to do? Are you going to inform the Order of this information that's come to light? Or do you want to take matters into your own hands?
I'd rather not do anything. I just want to continue spending my days just like this. Nothing more. After all, we have few days left.
You forgive him?
No. I'd rather Marlin didn't know. Imagine what it would be like to find out your father is a killer. You've helped me discover the truth, and I have no regrets. But Marlin's innocent. What would be the point of burdening him with this sort of knowledge? His smile is what kept me going all this time. His friendship is what saved me. I don't want revenge. I also don't want to be the reason Marlin loses his father.
If that's what you want, I'll respect your wishes. The case has already been closed, and the suspect declared dead. No reason to bring him back to life now.
Thank you. My family would have wanted it this way. I can almost feel them smiling at me from above. Besides, I wouldn't want anything like this to stop Marlin from baking those delicious muffins of his. I'll continue to chronicle my life in my journal, but only about the precious moments I spent with my wife and daughter. I just want to document my memories. I want to leave proof of their existence.
The scenery today is the same as yesterday. But for Renolf, nothing is the same. His entire world has changed. The past can never be undone. Yet, he has chosen to exempt a stranger from punishment. He didn't need saving, just someone to remind him of his strength and courage.
Good old Renolf, cheerful as always.
I'm grateful that I remember what happened in the past. I learned to forgive and to cherish everything and every moment of my life.
Do you remember the sound of the ocean waves? Breaking a long time after time. Believing in magic can make you strong. Tell everyone that this is a place where you belong. Everything looks shiny in the sun of day. to find yourself in wonderful world. Ah, everything feels like your fantasy. A night in your life. Close your eyes to find yourself in mystic timeline. Do you remember the touch of the wind on you? Soft to the whispers of angel that falls in love. Do you remember the sound of the ocean waves? Breaking a long time after time. Believing in magic can make you strong. Tell everyone that this is a place where you belong. Ah, everything looks shiny in the sun. A day in your life. Close your eyes to find yourself in a wonderful world. Ah, everything feels like your fantasy. A night in your life. Close your eyes to find yourself in mystic timeline. Do you remember the touch of the wind on you? Soft to the whispers of angel that falls in love. Do you remember the sound of the ocean waves?
A lovely lady.
Thank you for visiting.
Welcome to our hotel. We eagerly await your next visit.
Was it really the shadow of the dark?
You again? You're very persistent.
Here's some money. Take this, and show me what you can do, but don't cry for me. I want you to shed tears for yourself.
What? That's a first. No one's ever asked for that before. Why do you want me to do that?
Frankly, because I think you need it. Don't you think you do too?
I don't know.
Luca, you haven't cried for yourself in centuries. You say you're fine, and that there's nothing wrong. But that's not true.
Why not? Why would I lie?
I believe that your tears help mend people's broken hearts. Hearts that have forgotten how to feel. But every time you help someone, part of your own heart dies a little.
What?
When you talked about the death of your acting coach, you weren't sad. You were smiling. It's as if you don't feel anything anymore. You don't know what it's like to cry for real anymore, do you? Just these fake tears in exchange for a little money. What's become of your emotions?
I still have them, really. I can cry for real. All I have to do is think of the past.
Okay, then show me.
Huh. It's not working. That's weird. It's usually so easy. Huh. Why?
Time has taken everything from you, including a part of yourself. You've forgotten how you used to feel back then.
Stop it! Don't say that! That's not true at all. I remember everything. I remembered I loved him. And to this day, I still do.
Luca, I know. It's okay.
No, it's not. If I can't cry, that means my heart is gone. It means that it's been destroyed. I don't want to believe that. I won't.
I knew you had it inside you. And you proved it.
I'm crying. These tears, they're real.
I can tell. They look pretty real from here, too. I'm sorry if what I said was harsh, but it was for your own sake.
Thank goodness. My heart is okay. It's not broken. Wait. This wasn't your plan all along, was it? To help me realize the past that I'd forgotten? To save me from losing myself?
I just wanted to get my money's worth in tears. After all, I've donated more than enough. Besides, I couldn't just sit back and watch you waste away trying to help others. Someone had to help you.
I don't know what to say. I can't believe that anyone cared enough to help someone they hardly know. Thank you for opening my eyes. I'm going to stop selling my tears. I'm done.
Good.
It's okay to cry because you care about someone, but crying because people pay you to isn't what I want to do anymore. From now on, I'm going to show people my bedazzling smile instead.
Welcome to our hotel.
Let life still linger, if only for one more day.
You survived another day.
It's rude to keep people waiting.
This girl, she's got something she wants to ask.
What girl? Are you talking about that shadow?
Yep, and guess what? It's someone you know. Okay, you can come out.
Yule.
There are people here. They want to see you.
friends. Huh? Hold on. What's going on? Oh, did you see that? They want to lend a helping hand, but you're too far. Even though they know what you're really feeling, what you need, they can't do anything for you.
I'm not looking for help from anybody.
Of course you aren't. You're God's handpicked savior, right? You don't need friends, or even family. That's why you can't find Sarah anymore.
Whatever.
Listen, you are the savior. You must gather the souls that still walk upon this dying world and lead them to a new world of salvation. But your sister's soul is invisible to you, and if you cannot see her, you cannot save her. You must ask yourself, if it means saving Sarah, will you fight God? One human does not have the power to defeat Benevelza. He is all-powerful.
Then I'll find another power. Something beyond me, whatever it takes, even if it kills me as well.
You cannot save anyone. Not even Sarah. Not as you are. Because first, you have to save yourself.
You should listen to her. She always tells the truth.
Right. Not like you. But she's telling me that I'm missing something.
Well, yeah. Haven't you figured it out? Ugh. I swear, sometimes I lose my faith in you. You don't even know the first thing about your own soul, but you think you can fight God himself. I don't think I've ever met anyone so dense.
If you know it all, then tell me. What is it I'm missing?
It doesn't work like that. It doesn't mean a thing if you can't figure it out on your own.
I have to save myself. But how?
Light, can you hear me? Are you hurt?
It's all right. I'm fine.
But...
Look, I said I'm fine. Now just drop it, all right?
If you're sure. But you will tell me if something is wrong, won't you, Light?
You finally learned my secret!
And thank Almighty God for allowing us to see another dawn.
Welcome in.
Come back again.
offer this victory to a dying world.
Step right up!
Oh, thanks a lot.
Thank you for your patronage.
You brought the chaos.
Require a room?
Sid Rains.
That was once a man's name, but now it means nothing. His soul has dissolved into the swirl of chaos. I take his form as a convenience, but I'm no more than a puppet.
All right, so who's pulling your strings? Benevelza?
No, not God. I am the voice of many, of the countless multitude who call chaos home. I am the speaker for the dead. Tell me, Savior, do you know the ritual they call Soul Song?
Vanil is planning to perform it at the cathedral. She says it'll release the dead from their suffering. I guess that means you.
Vanil has been misled. there is a truth she cannot see, a truth that lies within the unseen realm.
What do you mean? What truth?
You do not understand the role of chaos.
Huh?
The chaos will drown this world, but it's also the key to our humanity. When we die, we return to it. But only for a short time. When a man dies, his soul melts into the chaos, but the idea of it, of him, survives intact. And then he is reborn anew and returns to the living world. An unseen power exists in all of us. It's the chaos that we carry in our hearts.
Our souls are made out of the chaos, which is why they return to it when we die. But they survive there, waiting for a new body, which means you could be reborn in the new world.
If the Sacred One shows us the way, she is the only one who can tell us what to do. She has the power to guide us into the future where we can live again.
She can do what I can't. Vanil can bring salvation to the dead.
Yes, but she doesn't know what she is capable of. The Order has kept the truth from her.
Why would they lie to her? They preach salvation.
Only for the living. The Soul Song will destroy us and make you forget we ever existed. Murder on a grand scale.
You want me to stop her, right?
Yes. And then you must tell her what her real power is, so she can lead us to salvation.
Is this what you all want?
It is, but it is not God's will. If you answer our prayer, it will mean defying Bonavelza. Those who try to defy the gods end up controlled by them and are destroyed in the end. Like Cid Reigns.
I remember, Reigns fought for humanity and he was killed for it, but the spirit that drove him to stand up to the tyranny of the gods didn't die. I kept it with me. Chaos is in all of us. It's the stuff our souls are made of, and it's the reason that the dead live on in our hearts and minds.
Yes, the chaos unites humanity, a thread woven through all our lives, and it's a power God cannot see. Its potential is limitless, and that makes it more powerful than he is.
But now you're gonna tell me that it's nearly impossible to tap into. Am I right?
Yet it is possible. No one can control the chaos. If you want to make the power yours, you must have the help of those who are inside it. You know what needs to be done. You know whose soul you have to find.
You mean Sarah? Are you saying I'll be able to reach her?
You must. With the chaos, anything is possible. Find the invisible bonds that unite us across life and death. Do that, and you will have all the power you need.
Chaos. It was the key to defeating God. If I wanted to use it, I needed Sarah's help. But Sarah, how can I make you hear me? I reach out with every fiber of my being, but is it enough? Can I do more? If I throw myself into the abyss, if I cry out to you, will you hear me, Sarah? Will you answer? Hold the world aloft. Give me another day.
Are you doing okay, Light? Light, the end is almost here. One more day, and then the destruction of the world will be complete.
Right. And there's no way I can delay it any longer.
No. This is it. You can still carry out your mission as the Savior, but today is your last chance. Tomorrow in the cathedral, Vanille will perform the soul song for the Order. The final rites, when the souls of the dead will be released from their torment and returned to oblivion. And when the clock strikes the hour, it'll mark the end of everything.
It's an ending that not even God has the power to stop. Hope, tell me something. You said that the souls of the dead return to the Chaos, right? If that's true, then that's where Sarah must be. Her soul is lost out there in the Chaos somewhere.
For God, the Chaos is an unseen realm. He cannot see inside. And so it follows that he doesn't have the power to find her as long as she is in the Chaos. But he can do something else. He can make her anew.
But then how can she be the real Sarah? The one I know?
Well, don't you trust him? It's true that even with all his power, God cannot extract Sarah's soul from the Chaos. But there is another place he might find it. He could take her soul from inside of you.
How would... You're just making things up now.
You always found it hard to trust people. What chance does God have? Look, I'm not saying you will. But if you do decide to turn against him, you should know that I'll always stand with you. You trust me, don't you?
It just seems like the more I search, the further away I get from finding her. I've encountered more than a few ghosts from the past now, talked to souls from the Chaos even, but I'm still no closer to finding Sarah, not even a hint.
I don't know, but perhaps you've done everything you can. Maybe you could have found her already, but something is keeping her from talking to you.
Like she doesn't want to see me?
Of course I don't think that's the case. But it's possible. Perhaps it's because you're too close to each other.
You mean she's out there and can talk to other people, but not me. Tell you what, why don't you go out there and look for her in my place?
I'd like to help, Light, but I can't leave the Ark. How about this? If I happen to die before you do, for whatever reason, I'll make you a promise. I'll try to find her in the Chaos, and when I do, I'll find some way for you two to be together again. Feels like the end now. Soon it'll be over.
It's been dying for 500 years.
I wasn't talking about the world.
Then what?
Never mind. Time is short. Every minute's precious now. Let's not waste any.
Require a room?
On this final day, please hear my last prayer. This is it. This is the true light of Yggdrasil.
Well, it's that time again.
It's day 13. That means the end of the world. That's what you said, right?
Yes, but something has changed. I don't quite understand it. The Tree of Life has borne more fruit, and it's glowing with a light that I've never seen before. I'm not sure, but I think this might be the lost time. We're getting it back, here at the end.
What do you mean?
Remember when I told you about the clocks? I told you how they only count to 12 instead of 13. There used to be 26 hours in a day.
But now there are only 24, 2 hours less. And the clocks changed when the chaos was unleashed. You think that the lost time still existed somewhere?
Yes, through a tear in the fabric of space-time, perhaps. But now it's come back, thanks to you. I think it was the excess Aradia that you harvested. Somehow, you accumulated so much that the distortion in the space-time was repaired, and we got back all those missing hours from the last 12 days.
That's 24 we didn't have. Which means we've been given a reprieve, one more day before God awakens and the final destruction begins. Just the one day, it's not a lot of time.
Yes, but it's enough for what I want you to do. I detected a previously unknown ruin deep in the Dead Dunes. Its appearance coincided with the return of the lost time.